I am going to solve this problem 139. In this problem, it is said that using the principles to be developed in chapter 3 on equilibrium, one can determine the tension in cable AB is 143.4 Newton, right? So it is said that the tension in this AB cable is 143.4 Newton, right? The magnitude of that tension. So it is said that determine the moment about the x-axis of this tension force acting on point A, right? So we are required to find the moment component along the x-axis, right, when this tension T is acting at this point A. And it is said that compare your result with the moment of the weight of the 15 kg uniform plate about the x-axis, right? So it is said that also calculate or compute the moment at this point G due to this weight and compare both of these, right? The moment due to this tension in this cable and the moment in due to this weight, right? So compare those. And then it is also said that what is the moment of the tension force acting at A about line OB, right? So it is also said that what is the moment along this OB line? If I join this O with B, so what will be the component of the moment due to this tension about this line OB, right? So we will find it. To find the moment about A, first we will find this T vector. Let me draw that tension vector. So it will be, this tension vector is from A to B, right? So let's suppose that this is that vector from A to B, and this is that T vector, right? So if I write, so then this T vector will be equal to T magnitude, and this will be NAB unit vector, and this is equal to T magnitude AB vector divided by AB magnitude. So for this, first we need to find the coordinates of A and B, right? So this is not A minus B, right? And again, this is AB magnitude, right? So we will find the A and B coordinates, right? So to find the coordinates of B, it's easy since point B is in the XZ plane. This is the XZ plane, right? This shaded one. So this shaded one is the XZ plane. And what is the coordinates of this point B? So we need to travel 0.35 along the x-axis, right? So I will write that the coordinates of B are 0.35 meters. And then along Z, we need to travel 0.4, right? So since this point B is in the XZ plane, so the Y coordinate will be 0. And then this will be 0.4, and the units are in meters, so 0.350 and 0.4. To find the coordinates of point A, here we can see that this plane is making, this surface or this edge is making 20 degrees with this y-axis, right? So if I draw that, let's suppose if I highlight this edge, right? So this edge is making 20 degrees with the y-axis, and if I draw a line parallel to this z-axis, right? So if I draw a line parallel to this z-axis at this point, right? So this distance, let's suppose that this point is T, right? So this OT length will be the cos component of this, and this is 0.45. This length is 0.45. Let's suppose that this point is P, so this OP length is 0.45. So I can write it here 0.45, and this will be the cos component of this 0.45. So OT length is 0.45 cos of 20 degrees, and this will be the sine component 0.45 sine of 20 degrees. Right? So these are the two components. Now to reach this point A, to find the coordinates of this point A, we will write we need to travel this much distance from O to X, from O to this corner, right? So this distance is 0.7 meters. So along X, we need to travel 0.7 meters. And then along Y, we need to travel this OT distance, right? So this OT distance. So I will write 0.45 cos of 20 degrees. And then along Z, we need to travel this distance and in the negative Z direction, right? So I will write minus 0.45 sine of 20 degrees, right? So let me write the coordinates of A here. So this is 0.7, 0.45 cos of 20 degrees minus 0.45 sin of 20 degrees, and the coordinates of B are 0.35, 0 and 0.4. AB vector will be equal to, so we will subtract the coordinates of A from B, right? So I will write 0.35 minus 0.7, and this is I, plus 0 minus 0.45 cos of 20 degrees plus 0.4 minus, so this will become plus. Right, so let me write it here, right, so that few people should remember it. So minus 0.45 sine of 20 degrees, right, and this will be, this is J and this is K. So now if I solve this, so we will get that AB vector. So let me solve it. So when we solve this, so this is that AB vector and this is the magnitude, right? So taking the square of all the components magnitude and taking the under the root 2, so this is the magnitude, right? So now we can write this T vector. So then this T vector will be equal to, so this T magnitude, so what is that T magnitude? So T magnitude is this much, this is 143.4, so I will write 143.4, and we can divide this 143.4 by this magnitude, so this will be 0.78, and then we will write this AB vector, right? So this is minus 0.35i minus 0.423j plus 0.554k, right? So this is the AB vector, this is the T vector along this cable. So when I multiply this fraction with all of these components magnitude, so we get this T vector. Now if I draw these components of A in this diagram, right, so this will be that component along the negative x, right, and its magnitude is minus 64.35. so if I write, so then this will be T x component, right, and if I draw the y component, is also along the negative y direction, and this will be parallel to the y-axis. So first I will draw it here and then I will move it, right, so this should be parallel to that y-axis, right? So this is the component along y, so I will write that this is ty, right, and these components are not drawn according to the scale, right? So this component, the length of this component should be approximately until this point, right? This is the ty, and if I draw the component along the z axis, so this one will be that component, and that component should be parallel to the z axis, right? So I will draw it here and then I will move it and I will place it here, right? So these are the three components of this T vector, right? So Tx is in the negative x, Ty is in the negative y, and Tz is in the positive z direction, right? So these are the components of this T vector. Now we are asked to find the moment moment at O about x, right? So due to these three components, so in this problem it is said they determine the moment about the x-axis of this tension force acting on point A. So we will use the inspection method to find the moment about x, right? So if we inspect this assembly or this system from this direction, right, so let me draw that diagram in 2D, right? So from this direction we will be able to see this yz plane. So let me draw that yz plane, so we will be able to see it like this. So this will be the y-axis and this will be the positive z-axis, right? And this red one will be that uniform plate, and that uniform plate will be making 20 degrees, right? So this is 20 degrees, right? And this is the positive z-axis. So this is that point A, right? This is that point A, and here will be that O point, right? This is that point A. So now if I draw this component Tx will not be visible, right? So if I draw those two components, right? So one component will be in this direction. And this will be the ty component that I have drawn there, right? So this is the ty, and this will be one another component, right? And this one another component will be like this, and this is the tz component acting along z, and tx is into the screen, right? So now we are finding the moment at O about x axis is, right? So as we can see that this tx is parallel to the x axis, so it will never produce the moment about x axis. So only these two components are producing the moment about O along x, right? As these two components are having some perpendicular distance from the point O, right? From point O. So if I write, so then this ty, if I write, so then this ty is making the moment. And what will be the direction of that moment? This will be the direction of that moment. Here, if you want to mention that direction, so this will be that direction, right? And if we curl our right hand fingers in this direction, right? So our thumb will be in the negative x direction. So this will be our thumb direction. So the moment produced by this ty component will be the clockwise, right? In the negative x direction. And what will be the magnitude? So the perpendicular distance of this ty from this point O is this much, right? This much distance. And this much distance is this one, this tp. This tp and this distance is equal, right? So this is 0.45 sine of 20 degrees. So I will write that the perpendicular distance is 0.45 sine of 20 degrees. And if you want to represent this as a vector, so then this is in the negative x, right? So I will write this minus I, right? And if we look into this component and this 2D diagram, right? So the perpendicular distance of this tz from this point O is this much distance, right? And this is that OT. Let's suppose if I write, so this is that OT, OT, right? So this distance is 0.45 cos of 20 degree, right? So I can write, and again, this moment is about the x-axis, so we can add up these, right? And what will be the direction of that moment if I represent it, right? So that moment will be in this direction, about O. In this direction, right? Opposite to the moment produced by the ty component, right? And if we curl our right hand fingers in this direction, so our thumb will point out in the positive x direction. So this will be the direction, right? In the positive x. So this will be the positive moment about the x axis, right? So I will write plus, and this will be tz, and the perpendicular distance, so this OT, and this is 0.45 cos of 20, right? So I will write 0.45 cos of 20 degrees, and this whole moment is about the x-axis, right? So this is about I. So the moment at O about x will be equal to, so if I put the component values as well, right? So magnitudes as well, so minus ty, so this is the ty, right? So into minus 77.77 into 0.45 sine of 20 degrees plus. And this tz, tz is 101.85, so I will write 101.85 into 0.45 cos of 20 degrees. And this whole is about the x-axis, so we will multiply all this with I. So if I solve this, so this will be the moment at O along x. So when I solve this, so the moment at O about x comes out to be 31.1 newton meter. And remember that there is no need to write the minus sign, right? So we only consider the sense of the moment, right? So there is no need to write this minus sign. So then this is 31.1 newton meter, right? And further in this problem, it is said that find the moment of this weight as well, right? About the x-axis, right? So it is said that compare your result with the moment of the weight W or the 15 kg uniform plate about the x-axis, right? So again, if you want to find the moment about x due to this weight, so then this will be equal to, so this is 15 kg, right? So you will write 15 into 9.81. So this will be in newtons, right? 15 into 9.81. And what is the perpendicular distance of this weight from this x-axis, is right? So if I draw, if I mention that weight here in this diagram, right? So let me remove these components now, right? So if I mention that weight, so this will be that weight at the midpoint of this uniform plate. So this is that weight, which is acting vertically downward, right? And if I extend the line of action of this weight, right? And what will be this length? So this is the midpoint of this OA, right? So this is 0.45 divided by 2. And this is 20 degrees, so then this length, this is the this length is the, let's suppose that this is point M. So this OM is the perpendicular distance of this weight from this point O, or from this, that x-axis is, right? So this OM length. So what is that OM length? So OM length is equal to 0.45 divided by 2 cos of 20 degrees, right? So we will write 0.45 divided by 2 cos of 20 degrees. So when I solve this, so this comes out to be 31.1. And if you want to represent it as a vector, so then if we look into this 2D diagram, so then this weight will produce the moment in this direction, right? If I mention that in this green color, right? So this will be the moment direction, right? And if you want to mention it here, so this will be the direction. And if we curl our right hand finger in this direction, so it should point out in the negative x direction. So this means that this is minus 31.1 I, right? So this is the moment about x due to this weight, right? And this one is positive, right? And this is in the positive I direction, right? So as we can see that both of these are canceling each other, right? So then this uniform plate is in equilibrium, right? So this is, again, this is the answer given. So this mx 31.1 newton meter, and due to weight, this one is the counterclockwise and this one is the clockwise, right? And now in this problem it is also said that what is the moment of the tension force acting at E about line OB. So if I draw that line OB, so this will be that line from O to B. So as we can see that this T vector is intersecting this OB line, so this T vector will never produce the moment about this OB line. So remember that whenever a line or a vector intersects a given line, so then it will never produce a moment about that line, right? That arbitrary axis. And similarly, if this T vector is, if a given vector is parallel to a given line or a given arbitrary axis, so it will never produce a moment about that axis, right? So remember, so there are two conditions that I have stated here. So whenever a given force is intersecting a given arbitrary axis, so it will never produce a moment. And if a given vector is parallel to an axis, an arbitrary axis, so it will never produce a moment about that axis. So remember these two points.